Good morning, all of you. Today I am discussing about the introduction to bioinformatics. So today I am covering the topic of the introduction to bioinformatics, history about the bioinformatics, then the aim, importance of bioinformatics, and the most important part is the application and the benefits of the bioinformatics in life science, and another most important is the research area of bioinformatics. Now, first of all, you all are aware about the biotechnology field. The biotechnology field is itself an interdisciplinary field. It contains genetics, molecular biology, animal tissue culture, plant tissue culture, there are etc. The number of fields contained in biotechnology. The bioinformatics is one of the most important fields in the bioinformatics, in the biotechnology. The bioinformatics itself is an interdisciplinary field. The definition is that the bioinformatics is an interdisciplinary scientific field that develops methods and software tools for storing one particular data, retrieving that data, and the organizing and analyzing a biological data. That means the particular by using a software or tools, we are able to retrieve the data and the store in one particular database. As an interdisciplinary field, bioinformatics combine computer science, second statistics and mathematics, and the third one is the engineering study biological database. See, this diagram is the perfect shows the role of bioinformatics. The bioinformatics is in the center. The three main interdisciplinary field is the computer science, biology, and the mathematics and statistics. Bioinformatics are gave some knowledge from the biology or the molecular biology. Then through this knowledge, by using this knowledge, we are make some specific algorithm by using mathematics and statistics, and through this algorithm we are able to use the computer science for the new discoveries. So it is the circle, like the clockwise manner, it is continuously grow a number of data, so we will get a humorous or say the number of data database at the end of the whole circle. So the bioinformatics, it is the continuously growth or continuously development field. The aims of bioinformatics, there are a number of aims of this field. The first one is the improved content and utility of the database. That means if right now we have some content, we want to improve a number of content and even the quality of content. So it is the main aim of the bioinformatics. Second one is the develop better tools for data generation, capture and annotation. That means by using a number of software, we can generate a number of humorous data which is a very new data. Next, the develop and improve tools and database for comprehensive functional study. Even by using bioinformatics, we can able to do a functional studies of the proteins. Next, the develop and improve tools for representing and analyzing sequences, similarity, and the variation of these sequences. That means if suppose I have a two sequence, then through this field I can able to check between the similarity and the differences between these two sequences. Then the create the mechanism to support effective approaches for producing robust exportable software that can be widely shared. If suppose I develop my own software, and then if suppose this software will be used by only my organization, then maybe it's some effectiveness, right? But if suppose my software will use by whole world, then it will be best effectiveness, then it will get a number of result, then it will get a very benefit or very useful for the world. Then the next one is the role of bioinformatics, the understanding of biological process. Bioinformatics is basically depend on the biological field. So the main role is the understanding the biological process like the pattern recognition, first one, Second one is the sequence alignment, that is the two sequence check between the similarity or variation between the two or more sequences. The third one is the gene finding. If suppose I have whole genome sequence and if I want one particular gene, if I want one particular identify one particular gene, so the gene finding is another role of bioinformatics. The assembly, if suppose I want to predict a whole genome, then I couldn't be able to work on the whole genome at a time and only me. So because I will what will do, so I can convert whole genome into the small fragments, and these fragments will send to the different organizations. So they will work on that particular fragments and they will send me the result, and then at the end I assemble this whole result and make one document for the whole genome. So it is the assembly part. Then the drug designing is the most very useful at the day, nowadays. The drug designing is a very useful software by the all pharmaceuticals companies, because through this software the pharmaceutical companies are able to do experimental analysis in the computer without the help of without the lack of experimental analysis. Then the protein structure alignment is the another role. Protein structure alignment means two protein structure are aligned to each other. The second one is the gene expression. That means if suppose the one gene, that is the DNA sequence, is converted into RNA and then protein, and then this protein will give some function. So the through the gene expression we can through the gene we are able to do the protein expressions. Now the genome annotation. Genome annotation is the one more role of the bioinformatics. This diagram is the perfect diagram to get a role of bioinformatics. See, if suppose you all are aware about the Ebola virus, the chikungunya disease, right? So this disease are just latest disease. The scientists were able to generate immediately medicine, immediately, at least not 100% curable, but at least we are cure such type of disease just because of bioinformatics. Why? Because suppose if my gene will get some produce protein which is abnormal, and if abnormal protein get the abnormality or say the dysfunction in my body, so might be I have a chance to get a disease. So the scientists were first isolated one particular protein from my body. After then they purify, isolate that protein and then purify a pure form, and then this protein inserted into the computer, and the different type of softwares, they copy the protein and add into the different type of softwares. So now my protein inserted into the super family software, so I will get a super families of this protein. Another software will get information about the protein sequences. Another one will get information about the nucleotide sequences. Another one like the whole bonds of the protein structures, then the side chains and the similar sequences about the protein I will get through different type of software. After that, I will combine or say assemble this whole data in a one file and make a one particular document. So if I will make a document, this document I will send to the pharmacologist. Now the pharmacologist read properly and make he has a very good capacity, or say he has able to make or say discover a new drug because of such type of data. So now the sample from a new patient, prediction of functional consequences, treatment suggestion. That means the pharmacologist now able to make a new drugs which will cure that disease. So because of bioinformatics we will get a very fast developed drug at very fast and the minimum cost. Now, the history about the bioinformatics is that this lady is the name of Margarita, Day of Margarita, the IBM 7090 computer at that time in 1965 or 70, which Margaret Dayhoff used for her early work. Margaret Oakley Dayhoff, who created the first large-scale database of protein sequences that is known as Atlas of Protein Sequences and Structure, and developed many of the algorithms even for analysis of relatedness of protein at early 1970s. Because of Margarita's work, the bioinformatics will grow day by day. And when in 1988 NCBI was founded, the bioinformatics growth is tremendously continuously. The National Center for Biotechnology Information, founded on 1988. After that, the important role of bioinformatics is the Human Genome Project in 1990. A Human Genome Project developed by the all worldwide scientists, they accumulate together and work on together on the one project, on Human Genome Project. First of all, the whole human genome converted into the small fragments, sending different organizations. They conclude their result on that. They return back to the one particular organization. All result will get and combine the whole documents. These documents will very useful or say very benefit right now. In 2001, after the 10 years, the 1990, the Human Genome Project was start, and in 2001, it is published the whole draft version of Human Genome Project. Now, right now in 2010, the understanding the function of all genes within their cellular organisms and evolutionary context of Arabidopsis thaliana, and the future, that means the our scientists' goal or aim is that till 2050, the completion of first computational model of complete cell, or maybe even already of a complete organism. So think about that. If the scientists will able to make a one cell in a computer, or say whole organism in a computer, then we will do a number of experiment on a computer base. We will get a number of information or number of knowledge about the organisms. So it will get a number of benefits to us. Now this is the serial wise history of bioinformatics, the whole year's histories about the informatics. Then the global why bioinformatics is so important nowadays. So the global perspective in experimental design, the ability to capitalize on the emerging technology of database mining, the process that is the bioinformatics, the process by which testable hypotheses are generated regarding the function or structure of gene or protein. It means it is the testable hypothesis generated regarding the gene or protein, and then they check or say similarity check between the pre-existed data and new data, and then stored again in database if it will new. The next, the although human disease may not be found in exactly the same form in animal. That means if in human, if suppose I have some disease, affected some disease, then it might be not able to the same disease or say same type of reaction get in animals. So the although human disease may not be found in exactly the same form in animals, there may be sufficient data for an animal model that allow researchers to make inferences about the process in humans, right? Now, why do we need bioinformatics? You know, before 1965, before 1970, the research growth, or say the rate of the ratio of the research was very very slow. It published around 8-9 or maybe 20 papers in a year. But after 1965, after evolved bioinformatics, now the number of paper, the growth of research, or say the ratio of research will be increased, will be increased till the 10 or even 100 times. And now in one year more than 8,000 papers were published. So the role of bioinformatics, it show this graph, the rate of research, the rate of discoveries, it continuously increased just because of bioinformatics. Now, the rapid increase in data due to genomics. Second, too much data to characterize genes or proteins individually. And the third one is the bioinformatics is equal to the smart use of information. You know, you heard about your parents, everyone's before 10 years, everyone say, beta, do a hard work. But nowadays, everyone say, do a smart work. The generation gap is now, see, the everyone say, do a smart work. So bioinformatics provide a smart information. Bioinformatics provide a smart use of this field. That's why it is the most important field in biotechnology. The ideally computational and experimentally biology are the partners. Next, the bioinformatics subject are used to for bioinformatics subject use, there are then some necessary skill sets. The skill like knowledge in molecular biology, it's very important to have a knowledge in molecular biology. Second one is the statistics and mathematics, that is for developing algorithms. The third one is the communicate biological problem to computer scientists. Fourth one is the working knowledge in bioinformatic tools. Next one is the computer proficiency like Windows and command line. And another one is the programming skill and the data administrations. Now the most important part in bioinformatics is that the application of informatics, because if we are doing any process, we must give applications, then only we work on one particular things, right? So application like the knowledge based drug designing is the most important application. Second, forensic DNA analysis and the agriculture biotechnology. There are the different type of applications in bioinformatics. Computational studies of protein ligand interaction, there are some another different type, and the knowledge of the three-dimensional structure of protein too. And the fourth one is this information based approach significantly reduces the time and most important cost necessary to develop drugs with higher potency, fewer side effect, less toxicity, and the traditional trial and error approach. So in forensics, result from molecular phylogenetics analysis have been accepted as evidence. And next, genomics and bioinformatics are now poised to revolutionize our healthcare system by developing personalized and customizing medicine. It is known as nowadays, it is this application is known as genetic counseling. Might be you will heard in next 5 years, it is the genetic counseling which is responsible for developing personalized and customized medicine. It will get a huge benefit to the human beings. And the most important part is the major research area is that the computational evolutionary biology, that means we have to improve our computational tools. Second one is the sequence analysis. The third one is the genome annotations. Fourth one is the analysis of regulations. And in cancer analysis of mutations, and the important part is the comparative genomics. So overall, the bioinformatics is the smart use of technology, it reducing our cost, reducing our time, our efforts. Because of that much of qualities, bioinformatics is a very, very most important part in the biotechnology field. Thank you.